Hello learners, welcome back for the new video. In this video we will design a sedimentation tank which is of rectangular type for a water treatment plant. So let's start. We have a problem statement. Design a rectangular type sedimentation tank for a flow of 12 MLD for a detention time of 6 hours and velocity of flow is 20 cm per minute or 0.2 meter per minute. Okay, this is the given data. If this data is not given, that means retention time is not given, velocity of flow is not given. In that case, you have to assume these two values. And the design consideration for that is, so let's see what is the design considerations. What was that? Detention time. Okay. Detention time for plain sedimentation, that means plain sedimentation means in that there is no coagulation done prior to the sedimentation. Okay. For that, the detention period is 3 to 4 hours. And in that case, the surface loading is 15 to 30 meter cube per meter square per day. And for horizontal flow circular type sedimentation tank, the detention time is 2 to 2.5 hours and the surface loading is 30 to 40 meter cube per meter square per day. And for vertical flow circular sedimentation tank or clarifier, 40 to 50 surface loading and detention time 1 to 1.5. Okay. But in our problem statement, this value is already given, so we don't need to assume that value. So let's directly start with the design. So first we have flow rate 12 MLD. We need to convert it into meter cube per hour. So 12 into 1 million means 10 raised to 6 liter per day. 12 into 10 raised to 6. I will split 10 raised to 6 into 2. 10 raised to 3 and 10 raised to 3 liter per day, because 10 raised to 3 liter per day means meter cube, 1 meter cube. 12 into 10 raised to 3 meter cube per day. This is 12,000 meter cube per day. Okay, I have to convert it into meter cube per hour. So I will divide 12 into 10 raised to 3 by 24. We will get the value of flow rate in meter cube per hour. So the value of Q in meter cube per hour is, I think it is 500, let me confirm, yes, 500 meter cube per day. This 500 meter cube per hour, okay. Sorry, 5000. Yes, it is 500 meter cube per hour. Okay, then this is the conversion of flow rate from million liters per day to meter cube per hour. Now we have to find the dimension of rectangular type sedimentation tank. So we need to take the detention period that is given as 6 hours. So detention period is 6 hours. We know the formula for detention period. Detention period is equal to volume upon flow rate. Volume by flow rate, we know that. Then volume is equal to detention time into flow rate. The detention time is 6 hours and the flow rate is 500 meter cube per hour. Then we will get the volume of sedimentation tank as 3000 meter cube is the volume of the sedimentation tank. Now we have to find the dimension. Here we have to find the rectangular type sedimentation tank, that means we have to find length, breadth and height. So first we will find the length of the sedimentation tank from the velocity of flow. This is the horizontal velocity. Okay, we know that the velocity of flow is given as horizontal velocity as 0.2 meter per minute. Okay, this is 0.2 meter per minute. Now velocity of flow is 0.2 meter per minute. This is the horizontal velocity. It means suppose this is our rectangular sedimentation tank. This is our rectangular sedimentation tank, and the velocity of flow will be this horizontal velocities, or let's take, this is the horizontal velocity VH, velocity of flow of water. That means the water is flowing from this side to this side, right side to left side. So we know that the formula for velocity is the basic formula for velocity is horizontal velocity VH is equal to distance upon time. Distance upon time, and here the distance is the horizontal distance, and that is nothing but length of the sedimentation tank divided by time, and this time is detention time, our TD. So in this equation we have the value of horizontal velocity, we have the value of detention period. So let's calculate length of the sedimentation tank. Length is equal to horizontal velocity into detention time. Okay, horizontal velocity is 0.2 meter per minute. Here the horizontal velocity, see here, the horizontal velocity is given in meter per minute, hence we need to take the detention time or detention period in a minute. So the conversion for from 6 hour to minute is, we need to multiply 6 hours by 60 only, you will get the time in minute. So after calculating this, you will get the length value as 36 to 72. The length of the sedimentation tank is 72 meter. Here we have found the first dimension of the sedimentation tank, and that is length is 72 meter. Now we need to find the depth and width. So for that we need to calculate the area. So we know that volume is equal to area into length. The area is unknown, and length and volume is known. Volume is, so area will be volume upon length. Volume is 3000 meter cube. Length is 72 meter. So you will get the area as 41.7 meter square. You will get the area as 41.7 meters. Okay, this area is you will get this area as the cross sectional area. Okay, because we have divided the volume by length, that means you will get the area in terms of other two dimensions, and the other two dimensions are depth and width. That's why you will get this area, that means this cross sectional area which is perpendicular to the horizontal velocity. Okay, now from this area we will get the width and depth. So for that we have to assume the depth of the sedimentation tank. So assume the depth for the depth, the design criteria is 2.5 to 5 meter, generally taken as 3, I will take 4. Assume the depth of the sedimentation tank as 4 meter, therefore width will be area upon depth. The area is 41.7 meter square, depth is 4 meter, therefore you will get the width as 10.42 meter. I will round up it as 10.5 meter. We have found the other two dimensions also, that means the depth we have assumed and width we have calculated, and already we have calculated the length. That means our design is completed. But in the sedimentation tank, there is at the bottom there is a sludge. There is a formation of sludge. So for that purpose, or the for the accumulation of sludge, we need to increase the depth for the sludge to be accumulated, and for the and we have to add some distance or some depth for the freeboard. So assume freeboard and sludge depth as 0.5 meter each. Okay. Then we have assumed that the freeboard of 0.5 meter and the sludge depth of 0.5 meter. So the total depth or effective depth will be depth is equal to 4 meter plus 0.5 meter of freeboard and 0.5 meter of sludge depth. That means the total depth will be 5 meter. Hence the dimension of tank R, length 72 meter by width 10 meter, 10.5 meter by depth 5 meter. Okay, this is one method. Another method is instead of assuming depth, you can assume the surface overflow rate, and from that surface overflow rate you can find the area, and after finding area and length, you can get the third dimension by the formula volume is equal to length into breadth into height. Okay, that is another method. Both the method are correct. So adopt any one method to design sedimentation tank. Okay, this is the dimension of sedimentation tank. Thank you.